We have tags in XML, recipe, titles, ingredient, instructions, these are all tags, and then the arguments are words in blue, so name, time, name, prep time, and cook time are three arguments for the recipe tag. And so from a technical point of view, XML is 10% of the implementation of SGML with 90% of its capabilities, which is nice, which lets you do a lot that makes it a lot less complex than SGML. XML and real biological words, so this is an example of a file that we would have gotten from the Arisig website. This is the pathway that I showed earlier. So this is what it looks. This is what the file, the pathway looks like when I download it from Arisig. And this is how it looks like when I get the file in another data format, which is XGTML. So as you can see, these files look enormously different. They don't look the same at all. Yet they describe the exact same thing. And so, what can we do? Well, one way traditionally to do things is that you can work with XML directly. You can download the .NET framework and use the system.xml workspace, or you can download the Java GDK and you can work with the JAXP or the DOM namespaces. And you can just download a bunch of files from different databases, from different websites, and process them one by one, just build a for loop or a while loop or whatever you prefer. And then you have two ways to actually process the data. You can either use DOM or you can use SAX. Now both of these have their pros and cons. DOM is very memory intensive, but it's relatively fast. And then SAX, on the other hand, it's complex code to write, it's hard, and it's very hard to ask the type of complex queries that you would like to ask in a biological context. Alternatively, you can take all these files and you can dump them into a single